What's up? I'm Jim Frohn. This is the Ready Check Pull quick preview of Anduin Wrynn. He's the 8th boss of the raid, and although he's not the final boss, Blizzard even said that he's on par with most final bosses, so this one's gonna have a lot going on. Alright, there's 3 phases, with an intermission after phase 1 and 2. In phase 1, your goal is to fill Anduin's willpower bar so that you can progress to the intermission. You do this by having some of your raid get hit by Anduin's frontal cast, which sends those players into a different phase, where they have some adds to kill and some adds to heal, all giving Anduin willpower once they've been dealt with. And when that's done, you have another group of entirely different players get hit by the next frontal, do the same thing as before, and voila, full willpower and the intermission starts. Now Anduin, of course, has some interesting abilities that make this process more difficult. He throws projectiles at several marked players that need to be aimed away and dodged. He puts a huge healing absorb bubble on the ground that players stack in while getting healed in order to make the bubble disappear before it blows up. He marks everyone with a yellow or purple debuff that explodes after a few seconds. Each player needs to avoid anyone with the same debuff while trying to connect with anyone with the opposite debuff. And lastly, he slowly stacks a dot debuff on everyone that only gets reset in the intermission, making you want to hurry up. In the intermission, a remnant of the Lich King spawns along with a ton of little adds. The goal is to nuke the remnant as much as possible because it transfers 150% of the damage it takes to Anduin, meaning it's just extra boss damage. Now I know it's tempting to AoE pad on all these little adds, but okay, yeah, let's be honest, everyone's just gonna pad on them anyway, so whatever. After a while, the remnant despawns and Anduin becomes active again and phase 2 starts. Phase 2 has all of the same mechanics as Phase 1, except the yellow and purple debuff mechanic is replaced by something totally different. There's a few purple caster adds that spawn and try to spam cast a raid-wide fear. You have to hard CC them and basically kill them one by one, being careful to interrupt every one of their cast. Once you give Anduin full willpower, you'll basically do the same intermission, but with some additional adds to dodge. After all that, Phase 3 starts, which is different from Phase 2. He still throws the projectiles that have to be dodged, and he still stacks a dot on everyone, even faster now, but all the other mechanics are replaced with just one mechanic. Anduin puts a debuff on everyone that explodes if one player gets close to another player, or it'll just explode after 25 seconds. The only way to clear this debuff is by walking into a zone of light or by soaking a light swirly thing. If no one soaks the swirly, it explodes on the entire raid, so make sure to stagger players clearing their debuff using the zone and players clearing their debuff using the swirly. Ultimately, this last phase is just the damage and healing check, because the dot on the raid stacks up real fast. You'll probably end up saving Bloodlust for this part and try to defeat Anduin before things get too crazy. Our official guide for this boss will be out early for our Patreon supporters, so if you're interested in that, or if you just want to keep us going, check out the links below. Peace.